I think I just agreed to be the single designer for a 4-story commercial building in Honesdale, PA. Can I do this? Or am I going to cry? Find out on the next episode of Kelsey Takes On Too Many Projects. Kelsey, and if this is the first video of mine that you're watching, welcome. I am a professional interior designer specializing in corporate office design, and I do many other things, but today I'm putting on my professional hat because today I am bringing you the first part of a huge multi-part design series. I recently got the opportunity to design a multi-story commercial building all by myself. This is a big project for me, probably not compared to the normal work that I usually do at my 9-to-5. I work on some pretty big projects for my actual job, but I'm doing that with a huge team of way more experienced people. This is the first commercial project I am ever doing completely by myself, independently, just me, nobody else. That's it, just me. Me, alone, by myself, independently, without anybody else, and no help whatsoever. Alone, completely alone. I have never done anything of this scale before, so this is a big undertaking. I'm really excited because I'm going to take you through the entire design process from my initial site visit, hopefully all the way through to the completed space. For that reason, I'm gonna be breaking this docu-series, I'm calling it, into multiple parts. I'm not sure how many parts that's going to be, but we'll find out how long this takes me to complete. This video is part one, where I'm gonna tell you all about how I got the project, where the project is located, exactly what I'm gonna be doing to this space, and show you what the site looks like. Of course, if you enjoy today's video, please do me a huge favor and subscribe so I can continue making more videos like this, and leave me a comment if this is something that you'd like to see more of in the future. I try to upload videos every Monday, emphasis on the try, so check back in then or turn on your notification bell to be notified the next time I post a video so you can catch the next videos in this series. All right, let's get into it. I just got off the phone with the client and basically just went over, you know, deadlines, budget, scope of work, how the project's gonna operate, and, you know, some other things that he's looking for. And so I need to now figure out how to create an itemized budget to just give the client a realistic idea of if his budget is reasonable, also factoring in my fee, you know, how much am I gonna charge him, what is reasonable. The goal of the project is to help him design the building that he just purchased, the 3-story commercial building. So it's going to be a big project to undertake. The scope of the work, thankfully, is just going to be furniture related, nothing architectural, which adds a whole another layer of complication. So that's a good thing. We're going to Honesdale. I'm gonna tell you about how I kind of got this project. If you don't already follow me on Instagram, quick plug, follow me on Instagram. I have done a couple of interior design related videos prior, and one video that I recently completed was a kind of like cozy cottage apartment video where I fully designed one part of my mom's house when I was sick with COVID in quarantine. I post a lot of snippets of my videos, like little sneak previews, on my Instagram, and so someone that I knew from high school actually was seeing some of my interior design stuff, and he reached out to me a couple of months ago saying, hey, I have this idea, I want to buy a commercial, like multi-story building in this town in the middle of Pennsylvania. And he was kind of telling me about this, you know, revitalization plan, and I was like, yeah, okay, dude, yeah, good luck with that one. And then like 2 months later he DM'd me and he was like, hey, remember that building I was gonna buy? Well, I bought it and I need a designer. And I was like, oh, I fully believe you now. Okay, I guess I'm doing this with you. His name is Mike. Thank you, Mike, for this amazing opportunity and for having way more confidence in me than I have in myself. So his basic business plan, which Mike, if you're watching this, I really hope I'm getting this all correct. If not, take it off my fee. Is to basically help revitalize a small up-and-coming town. The town that he actually found is called Honesdale, Pennsylvania. It's kind of an up-and-coming town. People see it as, you know, it's gonna be the new I don't know, some other town in Pennsylvania that is rejuvenated. I don't really know other towns in Pennsylvania besides Philadelphia. But anyways, his goal was to buy a multi-story commercial building, kind of invest in real estate in this town, eventually buy more real estate, and use this as a way to attract more young entrepreneurs to the town.
And now, a brief history of Honesdale, Pennsylvania. Honesdale is a town located in Wayne County, a borough nestled in the Pocono Mountains near the Pennsylvania-New York border, and is about 30 miles northeast of Scranton, yeah, the Electric City.
Scranton! What? The Electric City!
The town covers about 4 square miles of land and has a massive population of about 4,400 people. Woohoo! What flows right through the heart of Honesdale is the Lackawaxen River, which also meets up with the Dyberry Creek. Coal was discovered in northeastern Pennsylvania in the early 1800s, and there was now a need to transport this valuable fuel to New York City. This gave birth to the Delaware and Hudson Canal and the American Railroad. The town of Honesdale was founded in 1829 when the Stourbridge Lion, which is the first ever railroad steam locomotive operated in the U.S., was brought over from England. It was named after a guy named Philip Hone, a former mayor of New York and president of Honesdale, Delaware, and Hudson Canal Company, which is super ironic because since the beginning of time, Honesdale has been invaded by front-plating, trash-talking, loudmouthed New Yorkers, and that is exactly what is happening today.
Reporting live from Honesdale, Pennsylvania.
Long Islanders hit Honesdale and buy the town.
His name is said to be Pasquale.
Anyways. Because of its history of having the first steam locomotive, Honesdale is often known as the birthplace of American railroading. Even though the Stourbridge Lion made only one trip, in a circle, driven by a guy who didn't even have a train driving license, and it was deemed that the railroad track infrastructure couldn't support how heavy the train was, so it was immediately retired. Literally, that's it. That was the whole history of the train. Nothing else happened. I'm pretty sure they even started taking the train apart and shipping its parts to other towns for other trains to use. The town doesn't even have the real train anymore. They just have a replica. I'm telling you, it's a rich history in this town we have here. But now we have Honesdale! Imagine what life back then was like. No internet, no modern day worries, except the fact that everyone was pretty much miserable every single day of their lives and you were constantly in fear of dying of diseases like smallpox, scarlet fever, and typhus, and women had no rights. But look at all those horses! And now, a word on the culture, traditions, and people of Honesdale.
The town itself actually doesn't really have that much of a connection to the railroad. It doesn't really hold any of its culture. One local resident that I actually talked to said, in his opinion, Honesdale doesn't really have any kind of culture and that they've been desperately looking for one. And him and a bunch of other people in the town hope that this new rejuvenation and this attraction of a new younger generation will actually foster a new culture for the town. In terms of demographics, Honesdale is known for having multiple generations of the same families who are born and raised in Honesdale. Many of the stores have been there for a long time, for generations, and a lot of people have probably never even left the town. It's an everybody knows everybody kind of town, you know, small town vibes. In recent years though, as it has been kind of under this like revitalization, it has been attracting more young people, and then in turn more young, newer shops, restaurants, attractions. One of the local residents actually mentioned to me that he believes that social media actually had a big part in this, not only because social media is a tool to, you know, foster a more open-minded culture of people being more accepting to, you know, outsiders coming into your town and, you know, buying up real estate. And I guess, you know, more open to change in general, but also because it's really putting smaller towns like this on the map. You know, it's a place that a lot of people probably have never even heard about. It's kind of a trend that some people are noticing, you know, younger people getting sick of the cities, getting sick of where they're from and kind of moving and migrating to these smaller towns. You can see this too with the transition out of these old businesses that have been here for generations and in with these new urban businesses. A great example is a little coffee shop that I visited, Black and Brass. It is kind of representative of the new Honesdale. It's very urban, it's very young and chic, and you know, it's kind of something that you would see almost in New York City. The first step in this entire process was the site survey. It is 7:23 a.m. on Tuesday, May 18th.
I'm headed to Honesdale, Pennsylvania. Today is the first time I'm going to visit the site. I'm going to basically survey the whole building. I'm gonna go meet with some of the key stakeholders in the project and also like the main client who reached out to me and I'm gonna be working with. I'm also probably gonna like walk around the town, take a lot of photos and videos, see what the town is like. Talk to some local people. I just really, in addition to surveying and measuring the whole building and being able to like draw up these floor plans, I really need to get a feel for the town and its culture, aesthetically, maybe historically, geographically. All of those are gonna be really important in the design of the project itself, and they're gonna be the main factors for how I drive concept, so that's super important. I'm probably gonna be there all day, especially since the drive is about 4 hours, especially in this rush hour traffic that I'm sitting in. I just lost service. My GPS shut off. I don't know where I'm going, but Kelsey, you are good at directions, so you can figure this out. Oh, crap. Okay. Oh, I think I know where I'm going. Oh, no, I don't. Whoops. Sorry, dude. Sorry. Oh, my God. Thank God I'm back online. Oh, my Lord. Oh my God, I just had a like small panic attack, but we are back in business. Whew. I don't know which state I'm in exactly, but all I do know is that once you leave any highly populated area, there's literally not a Starbucks to be found. I have to, I guess, get Dunkin' Donuts. I mean, I don't really know why that's a thing. I mean, no hate towards Dunkin', but like hate towards Dunkin'. I feel like it's more sugary than Starbucks. Like Starbucks beans to me feels like a little higher end. They feel a little bit more like artisan beans. Desperate times call for desperate measures. It's weird because I didn't drink coffee at all my entire life, even all through college, because I never really liked it that much and I never really needed it because, I mean, I just have like uncontrollable amounts of energy naturally. But sometimes I would get like a specialty coffee, like a sweet coffee, and you know, that would be a treat. Even when I started working, I didn't feel like I needed coffee or wanted coffee that much. I was a big tea drinker. And I don't know what it is, but this pandemic has made me an addict. Okay, let's get back on the road and not get lost again. It's like 9:15. We have an hour left of the trip and yeah, it's a beautiful day outside. Yay! I think we're here. We're in Honesdale. Cute.
What's going on? My name is Mike. This is the Creative Compound. We are in Honesdale, Pennsylvania. We're gonna turn it from America's favorite small town to America's most innovative town. 90-day challenge starts today.
Wow,
that was a good
That was so plain.
What the fuck do you have to say?
I do this sometimes.
Our project is a three-story multi-use commercial building, not including the basement. On the first level is a coffee shop with a service counter and some storage behind, plus a small area for seating as well as a window seat. Although there's no elevator in the building, making it non-accessible to people in wheelchairs, there is a ramp on the first floor, making the higher portion of the floor wheelchair accessible. Right now, the upper part of the first floor is a wide open space that will soon become part of the Burger Cafe. There's one unisex restroom, a very small cooking kitchen with an oven hood, and there's also a really cool wooden bar that we'll be reusing. Making your way up to the second floor, you come into a long hallway. At one end, two more restrooms and storage closets. The other is a small seating area with an entrance to a large open room. The space used to be a yoga studio, which you can see from the boxes of yoga mats, blocks, and the very subtle branding on the wall. On this floor is another medium-sized room with access to two offices. This floor is going to be a combination of co-working space, collaboration and conferencing, and rentable office space. Finally, the third floor is a much more open area that will be the main co-working space. Another bathroom, an IT closet, a coffee bar, a small kitchenette, along with three more offices. The building's in very good shape, which is great considering we'll be keeping all of the floors and ceilings. I would argue though that each floor will be getting a solid coat of paint. Don't you fret.
thank you guys so much for watching part one. I will hopefully see you soon for part two. They might be out of order. It might not come out next week. But yeah, just subscribe to stay updated on when the next part's gonna come out. And I thank you guys so much for watching. I'm really excited about this. I'm really excited to make another full interior design video. And I'm especially excited to just design this project in general and to take you guys along. So if you love this video, please like it, share it with your friends, leave me a comment. And if you do all those things, I can continue making more videos like this. So yeah, have a great rest of your day. Thanks for watching.